1986, November 18th. India initiated a military exercise just a few kilometers from Pakistan border. It was just within a few weeks that India had deployed over 6 lakh soldiers and several squadrons of Air Force in that area. This was the largest military deployment the world had witnessed since the Second World War. What prompted India to undertake this deployment, which Western observers assessed had the potential to trigger another Indo-Pak war, or even lead to another partition of Pakistan? How was this problem resolved? In this video, we look at the Indian defense exercise called Operation Brass Tacks and the warning it gave to Pakistan. The war with India in 1971 had cost Pakistan heavily. Not only had Pakistan suffered a humiliating defeat, but also lost East Pakistan, which became an independent nation. Pakistan was determined to avenge this defeat. In late 1970s, Pakistan administration and its army had started abetting Sikh terrorists and secessionist movement from its soil. Pakistan continued its effort to destabilize India. Therefore, India realized that it was absolutely necessary to make Pakistan understand the grievous consequences of any misadventure that it might attempt against India in the future. It is this realization that prompted India's political and military leaders to launch Operation Brass Tacks. This operation was carried out in 4 stages. The first stage was in the presence of the then Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi and his cabinet ministers. General Sundarji, the then Chief of Army Staff, explained his plan to the ministers using a map and obtained permission for the operation. The next phase was planning. The general detailed his plans to his commanders using terracotta models to explain details. Using a small cross-section of the forces, General Sundarji held a mock drill to ensure success of the operation. This was followed by the deployment of forces in Rajasthan. Phase 4 was the actual exercise. Multiple army divisions were deployed to partake in the operation. This included 9 infantry division, 3 mechanized divisions and 3 armored division, 1 air assault division and 3 armored brigades. In addition, Jaguar and MiG-27 squadrons of Indian Air Force were also positioned in the airfields near the border. On 18th November 1986, India started Operation Brass Tacks. The blueprint for the operation was very obvious. A preemptive airstrike would destroy Pakistan's nuclear plants and forward bases. Using the cover of this air attack, Indian Army would advance to Sindh province. By taking support from secessionist elements within Pakistan, the army would then stay put, dividing northern Pakistan from the south. This swift attack would mean that Pakistan would be thoroughly battered and demoralized, and would have no chance to retaliate. In short, General Sundarji expected Pakistan to capitulate promptly. Ostensibly, this was only a defense exercise, but it was a signal to Pakistan that this is what they should expect if it tried to further interfere in India's internal affairs. Pakistan was shell-shocked by this exercise and concluded that a full-fledged Indian attack was imminent. So they immediately deployed an army corps to the Punjab border. In case of an Indian attack, opening an additional war front in Punjab was the only option left for Pakistan. Ignoring the troop deployment of Pak forces on the border, Indian forces continued their exercises for 4 months. Meanwhile, after confirming that Pakistan has grasped the message, India extended the hand of friendship to Pakistan. What followed was cricket diplomacy. India organized an Indian-Pakistan series in India and invited Pakistan President General Zia to witness a match. Accepting this invitation, Zia came to India. Not only did he witness the match, he also engaged in dialogue with the Indian leaders. Further to this, India wound up its military exercises even before the cricket series ended. Though everything ended well, Abdul Qadir Khan, the father of Pakistan's nuclear weapons, later claimed that Pakistan would not have hesitated to use nuclear weapons to ensure its existence if India had attacked it. While Operation Brass Tacks was progressing on the Western Front, India was carrying out another exercise, namely Operation Checkerboard. in Arunachal Pradesh with a strength of over 150,000 soldiers. With these two simultaneous exercises, the two messages that India gave out were clear. Firstly, India would retaliate strongly in case another nation tried to interfere in our internal affairs. Secondly, India is capable of engaging in a two-front war if required. Jai Hind!